everyone, welcome to the library channel. Thank you for joining us today. I thought this would be a good time to show you how to handle rare books and artifacts or anything you might want to take a look at when visiting a rare book library. Now, it's important to note that every single library has its own rules and regulations, but there are some things that generally apply to all rare book libraries. So for example, one place where libraries might differ is their stance on whether or not you can take photographs of the manuscript or the rare book. You would probably find this information in advance on the library website, but sometimes you could just ask the people there in advance. Some libraries are very strict when it comes to their items. They're under copyright or they belong to the institution and you must fill out some paperwork before even taking one photograph. Whereas others encourage it and they want you to promote their rare books on your social media or, you know, share it with as many people as you want. So it all depends on where you are. Just make sure you ask in advance. But the general rules that apply to all rare book libraries include stuff like what you're not allowed to do around rare books. So the first thing you want to do after you've requested your item is to make sure that before you enter the library and are ready to handle the materials, you have washed your hands, because you might have ink from handling a pen earlier in the day, or a marker or highlighter, or maybe you were painting. You never know what you might have on your hands that could then attach themselves to the book that you're handling. And this stands also for a pencil, like if you're drawing and you have, you know, graphite on your hands, you don't want to accidentally smudge that onto the book that you're handling now. Now, a common misconception now is to think that everyone who handles a rare book must have gloves, and you probably have seen people wearing cotton gloves. There are images on the internet circulating with people with gloves handling rare books. However, that is not necessarily true. In fact, the argument is now that gloves are more likely to help you damage the book instead of helping it. So the best thing you can do is have clean hands and approach your book with your hands so you can handle it better. But you might need gloves when, one, the book you're handling might be hazardous, it might have mold or any chemicals on it that are unsafe for you. And second, when you're handling albums or photographs and vinyls, there are different approaches for different kinds of materials. You want to make sure you know what the approach is for the material you're about to use. A few things you should know is that you're not allowed to have coffee, tea, any kind of beverage or food near your rare book. And this is definitely not a case of librarians wanting you to be dehydrated. You can certainly step out of the room and have a break and drink, eat, whatever you want. But while handling the material, you do not want to risk having anything near it that might damage it or smudge it. And this also includes colored pens and markers or any kind of colored crayon, and definitely no pen, because there could be a leak from your pen and you do not want that to go onto the manuscript or the rare book. This pencil will be your best friend. If you want to take notes, you will use a pencil. A lot of libraries also allow people to bring in their laptop now, and you can take notes. And again, you could do a transcript, but you can't publish it anywhere. You have to keep in mind all the rules and regulations of the library, and make sure you double check when it comes to taking photos again, even if it is for your personal use only and for your laptop. You want to use that laptop only for the internet and for taking notes. Now, there are things you can ask your librarian for, or the person who is supervising you in that space. And a lot of people don't know you can ask for these things, which is why I feel like it's very important to mention it. So a lot of libraries will have these things called book cradles. They're usually made out of foam, and they're the things that keep a book open on the table. And these cradles are often used as well during exhibitions, and they make it very easy for the book to not open all the way to risk damaging the cover or the spine and breaking it entirely. Now, we have these foamy pillows and I'll show you how to use them in just a second, but you can also ask for a ruler, because a lot of bibliographers will need to measure books. You're also allowed to ask for a magnifying glass. These are usually allowed, different kinds. So make sure you ask and you examine which one you need. You will also be allowed sometimes to get a light. These are usually little flashlights that you can use in order to examine the book closer, to look for watermarks or for chain lines. So definitely ask for one of those if you're at a rare book library. They will have that there for you. And the last thing that I would recommend asking for, and these I found to be very useful for myself as well, are weights. So we have these little weights that look like hacky sacks. Also ones that look like this, and I'll show you in a second how to use these. This will help you keep the book open at the page you want, especially if you want to take notes in that time or transcribe it onto your laptop. But it will keep it open without damaging the book, without getting it dirty. And it is heavy. I know you can't really tell, but this is actually very heavy. And it will be very useful to keep the book open without forcing it too much. Another thing I'll mention before the demonstration is that just because a book looks newer does not necessarily mean that it's not rare. For instance, you might see books like these, which were published in 2017 or 2007, and you're thinking, okay, these look new, they have a very shiny cover and jacket, I can probably get this at my local bookstore. That's not necessarily always true. Just because a book is new does not mean it's not rare. Some books might be brand new, just printed yesterday, but there's only 7 copies of it in existence, and we just happen to have one of it. So just because you see something that looks newer does not mean that you can begin to handle it in a disrespectful way, or to start bending pages or doggy earing or cracking the spine. Okay, so here we have our fluffy pillow, and we're trying to look at this codex of Survey of London by John Stowe from 1633. Now, the book is pretty intact, but what I'll try to do is create a space here for the spine of the book to lie down comfortably. This will ensure that when you open it, it won't force this all the way down to the point where you might damage it. And also add additional pillows to ensure that this doesn't go all the way. As I've mentioned, some other libraries might have foam cradles instead of these pillows, so you definitely want to use all of the tools at your disposal to ensure that you take good care of this book. And at that point, you just want to start looking at it carefully, examining it up close, using your hands and your fingers to flip the pages as you normally would. Let's say you're at this page and the book kind of wants to keep closing, and this page just won't stay still because it's partway through the book. It's at this point where your weights will come in handy, especially the string. So what most librarians do is they will place this weight across like so, and this will ensure that your page stays open without you needing to force it. I like to pretend it's a baby and I'm just putting a cushion under it. So in this case, this page right here won't really stay open. And it's been repaired. You can see somebody has cut this before and now it's damaged. So if you wanted to transcribe this page, this is probably as far as you could force this page to stay open without risking putting too much strain. There will also be instances where you're handling a book that's already been damaged, and it's not somebody's fault necessarily. It could just be age. The glue has deteriorated in the spine, and clearly you can see that the front cover board is detaching. So the librarians often use string to keep it all together. And while you want to undo this very carefully to look at the book itself, and here you want to ensure you don't damage it any further than it's what's already missing. So this you can place aside and take a look at your codex. Very carefully. So now when it's time to put this away, what you want to do here is do not try to attempt to retie this yourself. That is not recommended. That is why the librarian and the conservator is in the library. They will help you do this. So please just return this item back to the librarian in this way with the string,
but do not try to attach it yourself.
This rule applies not only to the books and to the archives or photographs, it will apply to the artifacts as well. Let's say you're looking at a tablet or a rock or something that has some form of writing on it or a hieroglyph of some sort, and it's come packaged in a very particular way. You do not want to attempt to now package it the way you found it, because there are people trained to do all of that very carefully. And this way you don't risk putting yourself in the danger of being the one to have ruined it. Because with this book, for example, if you're suddenly trying to figure out how to flip it and put all the string together, you might actually drop it or harm it even more. And you definitely don't want that. Lastly, and this is more for you than anyone else, please make sure that when you come into the library, you will have some clothing you don't necessarily mind getting dirty, because there will be a lot of dust coming off of the books, but also the sort of red rust coming off the spines of really rare books from the 1600s or after that. I've gotten a little glimpse of that just now, so just beware that you might have some of that dust on your hands and you might get some on your clothes. So just be aware of that before you go in and be prepared to wash your hands afterwards as well. That's it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in our next library video. Bye!